WWF Championship Wrestling. Here at ringside, Vince McMahon along with wrestling great Butch Patterson. And this week, we take a look at the phenom known as Superfly Snuka.
Well, I've said it so many times, Vince, and everyone agrees with me. He's one of a kind, and he's the one wrestler. When you see him in the ring, you want to see him more. You want to see him more often. You want to see him fly. He's really, really something special.
And speaking of something special, last week we, of course, had with us in Buddy Rogers' corner, Apa Sika, with their special guest. Well, we saw them with their snake, their mascot, if you would. And now, this week, we're going to see them in tag team action, and they are nothing short of devastating.
Well, every time the Samoans gets in the ring, it's always chaos, especially with Lou Albano in the ringside. And last week, as I mentioned on television, I wasn't surprised to see them with a snake, but I would have thought that team with a skunk, maybe, instead of a snake.
Also scheduled to join us in another tag team. They were quite impressive last week, the Invaders.
They did. That was very impressive. As I said, I've heard a lot about them. They were a great team, but I've never seen them before. Last week was the first time, and they were very impressive.
We'll be back with the opening contest with Superfly Snuka in just a moment.
On the opening contest, it is scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my left, from Santo Domingo, weighing 240 pounds, it is Israel Matea. And his opponent, from the Fiji Islands, weighing in at 250 pounds, it is Jimmy Superfly Snuka.
Superfly. Preparing for his matchup. Yes, indeed. Mr. Snuka, a favorite, to say the least.
Everyone.
No one, I beg your pardon, huh?
Everyone loves to see him. They want to see him fly, and as you know, he's really something special.
No one in pro wrestling can do what this man does. We're set for action, Matea against Snuka. Matea side headlock on Mr. Snuka. Got under the throat there of Jimmy, caught him off guard. Referee asking to see if that was a clinch fist. It wouldn't matter if it were or not. Thrust under the throat there. Turner's going to take a toll back.
Definitely. I'm sure it was a fist right in the throat. The question by the referee, well, the referee did not see it, so he has to question it. I tell you, Snuka looks better than ever. What an athlete.
And again, from our vantage point, we can see Matea hammering away, that time with a chop to the head of Snuka. Snuka just gets his head, says, uh-uh, brother, you got one coming. Gets in a mid-second. Snuka with a shot, what a throw. Snuka all over Matea. Superfly Snuka wrestling barefoot, picks him over, right on top of Matea.
Boy, really pulling on the pressure on that reverse headlock. He looks aggressive to me.
He is aggressive.
Tell you, outside of the ring, you can't ask for any better guy than Snuka.
Look at this. Ooh, front to the throw. Superfly Snuka now. Look at that, Matea, right up in the air, no pop at all. Snuka drops the knee on Snuka, going out of the apron. Snuka going up to the top rope. Superfly Snuka, good, yeah, with a headlock. All right, Superfly Snuka gets the go. Tremendous ovation for this extraordinarily gifted athlete. We get the official time.
It is the time, 2 minutes and 40 seconds, and the winner, Jimmy Superfly Snuka.
Superfly Snuka, yes, indeed, he is appreciated by these fans. He is extraordinary. Mr. Snuka.
Judge, on that plate, if you're going to, we're going to take you back to the 8 minutes of Bodyslam Challenge.
Well, there's a look at the latest World Wrestling Federation program with Snuka. We may talk, perhaps you talk about that leap that he just made off that top rope pad. I'm sure you remember tonight when Snuka, standing on top of a 7-foot-4-inch Andre the Giant, leaped from there, and they carried that opponent out on a stretcher. Nonetheless, ladies and gentlemen, we shall take you now to the incident happening not long ago, the Bodyslam Challenge. Andre the Giant and Big John Studd, here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Bodyslam Challenge this week is up. The money is up to $10,000. Here, manager Fred Blassie is holding the money, $10,000. And the challenger, ladies and gentlemen, the challenger this week, here he comes out. It is Chief. No, it's not. Ladies and gentlemen, it is like the challenger this week is, he'll be, here he is, Andre the Giant. Oh, I can't believe it.
Did you see the look on such face?
Look at these fans.
Standing ovation. Standing ovation for Andre the Giant. Big John Studd is shot. Big John Studd with $15,000 and 25 his hand. I would have surprised him. They thought it was going to be big trouble.
Someone slams John Studd finally.
There's no doubt about it. Andre the Giant, listed at 485 pounds, standing 7 feet 4 inches.
And the fans up in arms. They want to see the Bodyslam Challenge. It looks like Studd will have to let Andre go for it.
Last is scared of death. They really are afraid to lose that money.
Well, Gorilla Monsoon almost won $10,000. Freddie Blassie for the conference now. And looks like it's going to be on. It's going to be on. Andre the Giant, the most phenomenal athlete of all time, gets his opportunity. Andre, if anyone could slam huge Big John Studd, it's this man standing before him right now.
Andre wants Studd in the middle of the ring. He doesn't want Studd by the rope so that Studd can grab the rope. He wants him in the middle of the ring.
Listen to fans. Andre. Studd backing off.
Well, Andre is not getting excited. I'm sure Andre knows he can do it.
Here we go now. Freddie Blassie with all that money. Look at that. Freddie Blassie hanging on to Studd. Hangs on again. Oh, ho, ho. The money goes fine. Freddie Blassie holding more money. Freddie Blassie. Andre throws Freddie Blassie's money. Big John Studd on top of Andre the Giant. John Studd attacking Andre the Giant.
Big John Stunt. We're getting out of here. Well, John Stunt is really scared. Look at this. An appreciation for Andre the Giant stepping over the top rope. Well, I don't know, unless John Studd was disqualified, Andre is not $15,000 richer. Freddie Blassie hung on. Let's take another look at it. These fans selling full well. Here, look at this. Blassie going right in. Andre tries to scoop him up. Freddie Blassie himself weighs 260 pounds. From there, almost picking Freddie Blassie up off the ground. Andre says no, jump John Studd to the side. Now watch this. Blassie knows he's caught. He's caught indeed. The money goes flying. The money goes flying in the left fist. The fans indeed appreciate it. Let's follow it some more. Andre takes the money and throws it out. He doesn't want the money. But from there, Big John Studd attacking Andre the Giant, putting the feet to him, hammering away. Big John Studd going to work on Andre the Giant. Big John Studd, no doubt, has not heard the last of it. Now, ladies and gentlemen, in the next contest, it is a tag team match scheduled for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my left, at a combined weight of 460 pounds from Puerto Rico, here are the Invaders. And their opponent, the corner to my right, from Baltimore, Maryland, weighing in at 255 pounds, it is John Callahan. And his partner, from Puerto Rico, weighing in at 231 pounds, it is Matt Rivera. Matt Rivera, John Callahan scoring off against the tag team combination of the Invaders. We're set for the action to commence. In the air, one of the Invaders is Matt Rivera. Look at it, block. Over goes the Invader. And over goes Rivera. Nicely done. Well, I tell you, they sure do some beautiful maneuver. And as a team, they really look like they have their things together. Callahan down to the canvas quickly. The Invader flipping over, grabbing right by the head. Down to one. Huh? Tagging his partner. Invader number one stepping in. Up goes Callahan quite easily, quite a body slam by Invader number one. Ooh, side of the head, he really threw it in there.
Frequent tag, I'll tell you, this is very, very good.
Invader number two, jumped back by the chin of Callahan, and more pressure applied. Simply looking over at the partner of Callahan a moment ago. The Invader off the rope, over Callahan. Callahan obviously may have some superiority as far as size is concerned, but seems to be rather slow.
Yes, a lack of experience, and of course the Invaders, they look, they're really moving with a lot of speed, and they know what they're doing. They look well experienced.
Callahan off, the Invader has him up, has him down.
Tag is made, left him there.
That's rather embarrassing. Oh, no. He'll be there for some time to come now. These Invaders second round.
That is quite an impressive maneuver.
It is.
When Invader 1 will take Invader 2 and throw him into the opposing
set. Here is the time. 2 minutes and 26 seconds. Here are the winners, the Invaders.
The Invaders victorious. We'll take a look at the way they polished off their opponent. Here now, Callahan to the rope. Up and just dropping. I guess he must have knocked the breath out of him there, because it took all day for him to tag his partner. Off now, and look at that. Right down into the chest, the cover, and the three count put on him.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the next contest, it is set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my right, from Charlotte, North Carolina, weighing 250 pounds, here is Donald Kernodle. And his opponent, from Tulsa, Oklahoma, weighing 240 pounds, here is Marshall Bovee.
Marshall Bovee. A deluxe course trainee as Bovee sets up now, locks up with Don Kernodle. With Bovee, handling him quite easily thus far.
The Kernodle bench has been around for quite a while. He has a great reputation, and you can see by the way he moves that he's well experienced and great amateur wrestling background. Very aggressive young man. He's the type of guy that anyone wants to challenge him, he'll step in the ring with anyone. He doesn't care. He won't back down from nobody.
Another man on the top rope there. Bovee having his problems with Kernodle. Looks to me like Kernodle is really teaching him the wrestling lesson. Get wet on it, kiss it. Certainly taking his time. Drops like a sack of potatoes.
Kernodle is not even breathing hard, and he hasn't stopped. He's just
really well-conditioned young man. No contest here. Marshall Bovee is just all red where Kernodle is hammering. Look at the red marks all over his chin. Bovee, again, has spent more time on the cameras, I believe, than he has standing up. Bovee not in the same category at all.
Some strange reason, I just have the feeling that Bovee does not belong in there.
Bovee having his problems, the referee checking the submission hold, and for crying out loud, the man's already, look at it, he's giving up. Oh, he can't say I submit. He has his hand over the mouth. Bovee in the air. Not for long, I'm sure.
Oh.
Power slam. Three count.
Well, I doubt it if we ever see Bovee back in the ring again. Especially after that power slam. Oh, and all the punishment that he took.
Don Kernodle, victorious, as we get the official time.
Here is the time. 3 minutes. minutes and 19 seconds. It is the winner, Donald Kernodle.
Don Kernodle, victorious. And if you fought outside, I still don't think the man broke a sweat. No contest here at all. Scheduled later on. Apotheca in a non-title tag team matchup. Very interesting Rogers corner, I'm sure, as they always are. Salvatore Bellomo also will join us, along with Iron Mike Sharpe. And, of course, one of the only Polish power. That chewing gum must be awfully good.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the next contest, it is a six-man tag team match. It is scheduled for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my right, from Dawson, Georgia, weighing 240 pounds, it is Charlie Brown. One of his partners from Lynn, Massachusetts, weighing in at 223 pounds, it is Steve Thunder. And the other partner from Panama, weighing 220 pounds, it is Steve King. And their opponents in the corner to my left at a combined weight of 899 pounds from the Isle of Samoans. Here are the three wild Samoans.
Well, conspicuous by his absence this week, as we look at Afa, Sika, and Samula. Conspicuous by his after this week is the 18-foot boa, the snake that we saw last week. But as Buddy Rogers said, there's another snake out there, about a 6'1", and I don't know, close to the 300-pound mark. We're looking at him right now in the lower part of our screen. Captain, give me a break. Louis Albano looking on the ring attendant. We shall have action in the six-man tag team match momentarily. Steve King, wow, did he ever take a back body drop from Hoppa?
I tell you, just a look at the Samoans, three of them, the size of them, really something else. As you mentioned so many times, that they are tough. They can take a lot of punishment, those Samoans.
Steve King whips her up, Hoppa working, and no, back body drop, but no, nice one to the right, Steve King. Hoppa quickly tagging Samula. Lunge, on drive, takedown, Steve King. Takes down the younger Samoan and makes the tag of Charlie Brown. Charlie Brown working on the left arm of Samoa. Brown throwing the knees into the chest area. Brown backing off is Samoa. Over the reach zone face. Consultation now as the fans look on.
Charlie Brown to the center. Look at Samoa get close to his corner.
And Samoa now at the... Ooh, my, what a shot. You hear the smack of the flesh all the way back up here. Brown scooped up quite easily.
Ooh, look at that. One hand on his shoulder.
Now it's in a canvas.
That's what you would call a real fishing slam.
Two, almost a count of three.
Now we've got Afa, Sika. What's the third one's name?
Samula.
Samula.
Samula, Samula. Lou Albano calls it different names. of Charlie Brown. That's Snuka. Perhaps the most vicious of all the Samoans in there.
Apa, Snuka.
Look at Snuka. It's Snuka and Apa who are tag team champions.
I guess we've got Gaga outside the ring.
What was that?
We've got Gaga outside the ring.
Apa again.
Gaga. Alberto, Gaga.
Well, inside the ring, it's Apa. Charlie Brown hammering away on Apa. Those puppies are not going to have an awful lot behind us. Headbutt.
Oh, no, you ain't going to hurt that big Samoan.
All he's doing is serving to anger Apa.
Ooh, my.
Tag is made now.
Uh-oh. What's this?
Headbutt from the side of the head.
First, the bones are always walking around barefooted, no matter where they go.
Doesn't matter what time of the year either. Samula in there against Charlie Brown. Nice reversal. No, Brown missing. Brown reaching over and tagging Steve Plunder. See what he can do in the ring for the first time, Steve Plunder. Plunder whipping his Samoan to the corner. Uh-oh. Ooh, what a land. Wow. Pika stepping through. Big 300-pound Pika. Steve Plunder slapped at a canvas. You can actually see him bounce off the canvas floor. Wow. Back now, oh, Apa with a headbutt. Back leg now to Samula. Samula has Steve Plunder up. What's he gonna do with it? They're trying to, in one fell swoop. Oh, forget about it. Cover by Samula, lights out.
I'll tell you, there's something else. They're going to be champions for a long time to come.
Apa, Snuka, and Samula in the six-man tag team match. Look at this. Most respectful of each other to get the official time.
Here is the time. 5:39. The winner, the Wild Samoan.
The Samoans victorious, and we take you now to action we saw just moments ago. Here is Steve Plunder, didn't stand a chance. Snuka almost drove him through the canvas. Plunder almost out of it. Tag was made now for Samula. After Apa, of course, dropped that headbutt on him here, Samula will attempt to finish off the destruction of this Steve Plunder. Picked him up now, only to ram him down to the canvas, and then watch this, coming right at him. And if Plunder could see this, look at this. Ooh, my. Oh, unbelievable impact.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. My guest this week is Tito Santana, without a doubt one of the best wrestling Latins I've ever seen. And not only that, he comes on with a tremendous record in the football field, and he's cut quite a path. I mean, a superb path in the wrestling game today. And I know he's got some things on his mind that I'd like to have him bring it out.
Buddy, it's my pleasure just to sit here and talk to you. You're a legend. I respect you, and it's my honor to be sitting here and talking to you. But I want to thank the people from the World Wrestling Federation. I've only been back a few short weeks, and the support they've given me has been tremendous. I love it. I'm happy to be back. But the most important thing, the reason that I came back is because I came back after some titles. One particular title held by Don Muraco, the Intercontinental belt. Muraco, you've been dodging people. You don't want to put up the belt on the line. but with the people's support, I'm going to force you into a title match. That's my goal, and my goal is to win that title for me, Muraco. Le agradezco a toda la gente latina que me está escuchando. Vine a luchar aquí para pelear y representar a todos los latinos como yo quiero que sean representados. Me siento muy orgulloso de ser mexicano y estoy aquí para representar a todos ustedes. ¡Arriba!
And with that, ladies and gentlemen, we'll go back to ringside wrestling.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next contest that is scheduled for one fall, with a 10-minute time limit, introducing in the corner to my right, from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, weighing 220 pounds, here is Ken Jugan. And his opponent from Italy, weighing in at 235 pounds, here is Salvatore Bellomo.
Salvatore Bellomo against Ken Jugan. Should be an outstanding matchup here. Here we go.
Taking over Jugan.
Bellomo, certainly a lot more aggressive bat than the Bellomo of several months ago.
Oh, definitely, without a doubt, but he still has that European style, and he likes to, I've said it so many times, that's the way he is. He likes to beat his opponent fair and square with wrestling maneuver. He's got really the brawler type. You get him mad at the ring, you'll fight back at that punching and kicking with wrestling maneuver, and he knows a lot of them. He comes up with some beautiful maneuver now and then. What I mean by that is something that you've never seen before.
Nice maneuver.
In the last few months, Bellomo really got himself together, really lost some weight, really got himself in great condition. He looks a little thinner, but believe me, he moves a lot better than he did a few months ago.
Right. Nice takedown, jumping Jugan.
When you feel yourself going, like we just saw Jugan there, your feet are knocked out from under you. It seems to me that you have to do a certain something to protect yourself, otherwise you're going to land flat on your face. If you feel yourself going, is it often times more advantageous perhaps to go with it as opposed to you
better go with it, or you really fall on your face or fall on your head.
Or easily break a limb in that regard.
Definitely. You should better as well go with it. At least you can fall on your back and it hurts, but better as well just fall on your head.
Nice drop kick by Jugan.
Over. Bellomo down, Jugan over him again, right back.
Drop check.
Nice play time. Bellomo missing with that drop check.
There's a free looking little lady.
And Jugan right on top. Jugan hammering away on Bellomo. Jugan, however, doesn't really have all that much behind these blows. I know it doesn't appear, at least.
Doesn't appear that way, but maybe when Bellomo missed that dropkick, he probably hurt his shoulder. That's what his opponent is doing, working on that shoulder.
Bellomo off the rope, shoulder block, down goes Jugan.
To the rope again, over him, right back. And mule kick by Bellomo.
Up, Jugan, nice slam by Bellomo. Off the rope, here he comes. Down, ramming a knee to the shoulder, covers Jugan. Lights out and will be back.
Bellomo victorious, and we'll be back as we continue with Iron Mike Sharp. And don't forget, later on, we're going to have with us the Polish power himself, Ivan Putski. Well, the fans here are somewhat in uproar as apparently Iron Mike Sharp is taking exception to being called a wimp. He does not like to be called a wimp, and these fans are really getting it to him.
Oh, he's
now, ladies and gentlemen, the next contest is scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, weighing in at 282 pounds, here is Iron Mike Sharp. And his opponent from Atlantic City, New Jersey, weighing 244 pounds, it is Jack Carson.
All right, here we go, the action, Carson against Iron Mike Sharp. Sharp, unmerciful. He is just moving right, chewing him up, Pat.
Well, there's, all I can tell you is a wimp doesn't fight like that. I'll tell you, he's not a wimp.
He is not. Oh, charging! And Carson, I think, more than anything else, the momentum snapped him out of that corner, rather than him doing it on his own merit. Carson, throwing forearm. And out Iron Mike Sharp. Here we go. Oh, look at that. Just lowered the left shoulder and knocked down Jack Carson.
Tell you, Biz, that Mike Sharp is a very, very well-conditioned athlete. He can really go. He never stopped.
Definitely not. Carson out on the apron. Iron Mike Sharp outside of the ring. Ooh, look at this. Ooh. That's concrete he's on now. Sharp ramming the shoulder. And right back into the ring now, Iron Mike Sharp.
There again, adjusting or playing with his forearm brace there.
Carson being set up, a whip to the rope. Oh, no. Wow, what a maneuver. Oh, tremendous blow by Iron Mike Sharp, who's anything but a whip. And listen to the boos. Listen to this booze by this capacity crowd. In unison, whip, 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 we're saying.
Here is the time. 2 minutes and 2 seconds, and the winner, Iron Mike Sharp.
There's a look at Ivan Putski. The bell is just rung. Ivan Putski struck out four against Tony Colon. Colon, 240-pounder against Ivan Putski's lean. 257. Look at the difference in the way they're put together. Ivan, little display of that Polish power. The action has begun. Together. Pat, I think he looks better than he's ever looked in his life.
He looks fantastic. And I tell you what, I've said it before, when a wrestler steps in the ring with Putski, he likes to show you that he's powerful. He likes to show his muscle.
And that's not to show off, because he likes for other wrestlers to challenge him on his strength.
Putski using the buckle. Diving with a clean break. Tony Colon backs off. See, like, Colon was looking up at Putski almost in awe. He's really respecting Putski. Putski has his own style, Vince, and very, very successful. And he has a short fuse. When he gets mad, he's like a bulldozer coming at you. Putski taking him down in control.
Like you and I will eat an apple. And sometimes he comes in the ring, his opponent don't like the way he smells. I'm talking about his breath. But you don't care.
Well, I guess you take your advantages as best you can. Hello, hammering away on Ivan Putski. Putski looking out of the midsection. Back really on a tear as of late in the World Wrestling Federation. I'm sure we'll be seeing a great deal more of Mr. Putski in the week, indeed in the months to come. We go back now and take a look at the way Ivan polished off Tony Colon. Here now, whips it around Putski. Look at this. Man, if he doesn't hit you, he'll go right through you. Look at this. Whoom! Gets that hammer right down to the chest. Oh, my goodness. That's like running into a mat truck. Putski in complete control, and Ivan Putski victorious. As I said before, we'll be seeing a great deal more of this mass of muscle in weeks to come.
Welcome to Championship Wrestling. At ringside, this is Vince McMahon along with wrestling great Pat Patterson. This week, we're going to be treated once again to the presence of the Polish power, Ivan Putski.
Well, last week, he looked better than ever, and he wants to get to the top. He wants to get to the championship. And remember, Ivan Putski at one time was one half of the world's tag team champion. Remember that, and he wants to go that far.
Also scheduled to join us this week, Sergeant Slaughter, who has signed for a match against Tony Garea.
Now, last week, it was a great match against Jules Strombo, and, of course, Slaughter came on top. Now, this week, anything could happen in this match, because I know Tony Garea is not going to give up.
Speaking of Sergeant Slaughter, many of you will recall his challenge to the step test. Right now, let's take you to Bob Backlund, who at this moment, as you can see, in the background there is manager Arnold Skolin, timing Bob Backlund. Bob Backlund obviously has accepted the challenge. and will indeed be attempting to break his record as well as Sergeant Slaughter's record.
On the opening contest, it is scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my right from Mission, Texas, weighing 244 pounds, here is Tito Santana. And in the corner to my left from Boston, Massachusetts, weighing in at 240 pounds, here is Pete Doherty.
Oh my goodness. Pete Doherty getting something less than a rousing ovation here from these fans. Pete Doherty against Tito Santana should be an outstanding matchup to open up things here on Championship Wrestling. Up on his knee. Look at this, and the hard way.
Tito looking real good. He's more aggressive than he used to be. Heavier, more muscular.
Pete Doherty having his problems with Tito Santana, thus far at least. Fireman carry, Brayton takedown, nicely done.
And what a fine young man that Tito Santana is. Really, really a gentleman outside of the ring.
Nice maneuver. Santana truly a credit to professional wrestling.
He sure is, Vince. Really a great person.
Not that Pete Doherty is not a credit to pro wrestling, I guess, but just less of a credit, that's all. Look at this. Oh, my. Dangerous maneuver. Sunset flip. Does not get him. Tito has bulked up since we last saw him several years ago in the World Wrestling Federation. Really looks sharp. Easy takedown.
Pete Doherty always looks surprised when somebody makes a fancy move against him. Normally, Pete Doherty can handle himself pretty good.
Doherty looks like he's missing a few teeth there, especially in the bottom part.
Looked like he bit more than he could chew.
Take down by Doherty. Head scissor by Santana. Kick out. An arm drag takedown, nicely done, as Bob Backlund continues his workout, as does Santana and Doherty. Good look there at Tito, applying the pressure, leaning back away from the arm, knowing exactly how to use leverage to his advantage.
Well, he's putting a lot of pressure behind the elbow, which is, if you are in a position as far as Pete Doherty is concerned, you've got to be real careful because your elbow can really snap.
Off the rope. Stays with him, finally gets him down. Nicely done. Doherty, an unorthodox wrestler. And somebody like that can make you look bad.
He doesn't have a style, Vince, and you never know what he's going to do or he's going to come up with. You can't expect anything out of this guy.
Pete Doherty trying to snap over and indeed is successful. Drops a knee to the shoulder of Santana. Going out on the apron now, Pete Doherty. Doherty going up to the top rope. Taking his time about it. Santana catches him now. And it's going to be trouble for Doherty. Oh, my. Cover, two, still can't get it.
Well, at least one thing that Tito did the right thing. He covered him, taking the chance for the pin.
Santana continuing to work on the arm of Pete Doherty. Bob Backlund doing his thing, sweating profusely. Look at Doherty, not letting Santana up at all. Has him by the wrist, tries to set him up now, whips him to the ropes, off the rope, kick to the chest, nicely done by Santana. A right hand, Santana with another one. Tito Santana trying to set up Doherty to the rope. Back body drop.
Oh, what a back body drop that was.
Drop kick by Santana. Tito behind Doherty has him up. Atomic knee drop. Covers him. One, two, and still can't get him. No. Timekeeper made a mistake. The match is still in progress. Santana now, right back, bridges out, two, and make it three.
Beautiful.
Nice maneuver. When you pin a man that way, you can be sure he's going to stay down for the count of three.
Well, it's a combination submission as well as pin.
Here is the time. 5 minutes and 19 seconds. The winner, Tito Santana.
Santana with the chant, Arriba! Arriba! Santana on the victory. We'll take a look at some of the action we had. Here now, winding up is Doherty. Santana brings him up, down with the knee, hangs on, and in one fell swoop, great motion, right back. Boom, down to the bridge. Look at that pressure that has to be on the knee and the ankle. Combination submission. And right now we're looking at one of the greatest conditioned athletes in the world today. The World Wrestling Federation champion, Bob Backlund.
Well,
the winner,
I want to say Backlund does that every day and sometimes twice a day.
It's only one part of his training, although he is attempting to break his own record. And perhaps that of Sergeant Slaughter's step test record also. We get the announcement now.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the next contest, it is a non-title tag team match scheduled for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my left from Lexington, Tennessee, weighing 225 pounds, here is Eddie Gilbert. And his partner from Brooklyn, New York, weighing 235 pounds, here is Pete Sanchez. And in the corner to my right, from the Isle of Samoa, weighing in at a combined weight of 598 pounds, here are the World Wrestling Federation's tag team champions, the Wild Samoans.
Apa Sika. Oh my, talk about mean.
They've got to be the toughest tag team champions that I've ever seen.
Luabano, earlier on, he was walking up a little step there in his own right. It lasted for all of about 20 seconds, if that. Albano earlier on, of course, was looking over at the World Wrestling Federation champion, Bob Backlund. As Backlund continues with his step test. Should be an outstanding match in the ring, and Bob Backlund has a bird's eye view. Here we go. Thank you. And it looks like having a little problem. Eddie Gilbert. Into the head of the Samoan. These Samoans, as you brought out earlier on, Pat, perhaps the toughest tag team combination in World Wrestling Federation history. Oh, my!
What a chop that was.
They busted the young man open.
They did.
Above the eye.
They did. Gilbert is bleeding.
Gilbert off the rope, back, go, leapfrog. Oh, look at this. Oh, come on. Oh, my! Drop kick by Gilbert. Seeker takes a shot. Alpha down to the canvas. Referee's down as well. Sanchez tag now. Gilbert out on the outside. Over his man, down. Alpha spinning around the wrong way. Drop kick.
Alpha didn't have a clue of where Sanchez was.
Referee asking Sika to get the return to his corner. Off the rope, Sanchez missing Alpha. On target, Sanchez does not have much behind those punches. Eddie Gilbert back in. On the right side of Gilbert's forehead, he continues to bleed. From the cut, from Afa, from one of the chops. Busted him right open. Bob Backlund looking on.
It's going to take some special team to take the tag team championship from the Samoan, I'll tell you.
Oh, no.
Strombos can do it. I don't know who else is going to be able to do it.
Well, there's no telling. Sika now back in, hammering away. Lou Albano gives the nod. Good, bud. Sika and his Samoan tongue. Few words of wisdom, catches one to the breast, red basket, rather, another one now. Gilbert working away, tags off of Nasika, hangs on to Gilbert, Nasika, off of from behind.
Once you get close to that corner, you're in trouble. And look at that fast slub, Albano putting his two bits in there.
To the rope, Gilbert off. Back body, golly, Moses, he went up 10 feet in the air.
Gilbert has taken some...
Oh, push. Missing! Tigers made a Sanchez. Nicely done, Sanchez moving in on Hoffa. Hammering away, Sika looking on, does not like what he sees. Oh, now Hoffa turns it right back around. To the buckle. Ooh. Oh, charging like a fool. Hoffa, drop kick to his back. Off the rope, no, look at that.
Sika, pull the hair, get a handful of hair.
Up a headbutt. Off the second rope, that could, well, it definitely will be it. Easy three count now.
What a tag team combination.
Appa and Sika. Tough. Almost primitive.
Five minutes and 6 seconds. Here are the winners, the World Wrestling Federation's Tag Team Champions, the Wild Samoans.
Apa Sika victorious. As we take you to what we saw, oh my goodness, we didn't see that. I'll take you to what we saw earlier on. Here, to the rope, watch Sika yanking hair, grabbing whatever he can, and from there, Appa goes up to the middle rope, referee turns around to see what's going on. Sika reaches for the ref, referee begins to count. Alpha takes the dive. We'll be back. That's our feature match later on. But in a moment, we'll be back with the Animal.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next contest, scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my right, from Dawson, Georgia, weighing 240 pounds, it is Charlie Brown. And his opponent, from Detroit, Michigan, weighing in at 288 pounds, it is George the Animal Steele.
Fred Blassie giving instructions to the Animal. Look at that. Look at that physique. So hairy, it looks like fur all over his upper body. No hair at all on his head. Nowhere, not an eyebrow. Look at this. Look at this style. Would you? There is no style of this man.
There's none. There's none. There's no wrestling ability. None at all.
The Animal ready to lock up with Charlie Brown. Here we go. This Animal is unbelievable. Look at that tongue. Bob Backlund, I'm sure, is attempting to concentrate on it. Look at him, sweat pouring off Backlund, but he's trying to concentrate on what he's doing, but I'm sure he's distracted by just the presence, just the look at this man.
Well, I'm sure he must be concerned. You never know what this man's gonna do. Bob is really trying to concentrate. He's not even paying attention to the match, but I'm sure it's in the back of his mind.
Charlie Brown up that flying hammerlock. Brown bowing in submission. That's it. The Animal drops Brown to the canvas.
This man, I've said it before and I'll say it again, does not belong in the ring. This man should be suspended. He does everything against the rules.
Here is the time. 1 minute and 32 seconds. It is the winner, George the Animal Steele.
For a moment, I thought the Animal was going after Freddie Blassie. Now, what's he doing? Referee trying to maintain some order, but the referee somewhat in awe of the Animal as well. Ooh, my. The Animal wants Charlie Brown out. I'm sure he will get no objection to that. George the Animal Steele. There is one of a kind like this one. Thank goodness.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the next contest, scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my right, from Italy, weighing in at 235 pounds, here is Salvatore Bellomo. And his opponent, from Sioux City, Iowa, weighing 255 pounds, it is Bob Bradley.
Bob Bradley, power lifter. Bob Backlund continues with his step test. Boy, he is sweating profusely. We're set for action.
Thank you.
Bellomo against Bradley. Bradley wants to test his strength. Bellomo, further than that, takes him right over.
Bradley is a powerful little guy, but I'll tell you, maybe Bellomo is not as powerful as Bradley, but Bellomo has the wrestling ability.
Drop kick by Bellomo. Nicely. Oh, my! All the way out to the concrete floor.
Bellomo looking so much better. When he first arrived in the United States, he weighed about 250-some pounds, and he dropped down to about 220, and he built his body right back up. He's now 235 pounds, and he's really, really concentrating and working out.
And there's a test of strength. Bradley, if it's strictly strength, should do well against Bellomo. About that. In the midsection. Oh, my. So, Bellomo looks good.
He does. Good balance. And now Bradley is upset.
Trying to get himself together is Mr. Bradley. Bradley backs himself to the corner there so as not to be suplexed. The rope. Nice shoulder block by Bellomo. Headed that way again. Bradley stays down. Look at that. Nice maneuver. Bellomo, forearm uppercut. Bradley again outside, out on the apron this time.
Looks to me like he's out on his feet.
Blocked,
oh,
that one
blocked
is.
The punch.
And a rake of the face, it would appear, on the part of Bob Bradley. Forearms to the chest, to the buckle. Wow, did he ever hit that. Look at that. Outside on the concrete, right on his knees, on his elbow. I would suspect he very well may stay there. No, Bellomo's out. Bellomo whips him right back in. Salvatore wants Bradley in the ring. Off the rope, shoulder block. Down goes Bradley. Bellomo off the rope again. Leapfrog. New kick, oh my. Salvatore Bellomo, with a great deal of momentum now, has his man up, jumps him down, covers him quickly, hooks the leg, three count.
Very nice, very well done. Bellomo went outside of the ring, picked up Bradley, threw him back in. He figures, I can't beat this guy outside, I gotta beat him inside.
Here is the time, 3 minutes and 33 seconds. Here is the winner, Salvatore Bellomo.
Salvatore victorious. Salvatore well on his way to leaving a lasting mark in the World Wrestling Federation. We'll be back with the Polish power. Ivan Putski.
Our ladies and gentlemen, the next contest scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my left, from Santo Domingo, weighing in at 240 pounds, here is Israel Matea. And his opponent from Krakow, Poland, weighing 240 pounds, here is the Polish power, Ivan Putski.
The Polish power, boy, is he put together. The telecast being brought to you by the authority of the World Wrestling Federation. We'd like to remind you that any use of the pictures, descriptions, or any rebroadcast in general of the telecast, including the imposition of a charge without the express written consent of the World Wrestling Federation, is prohibited. Sort of bollocks that one up, but nonetheless, we know those good people out there don't want to have anything to do with rebroadcast anyhow. Ivan Putski sets his sights on Israel Matea. We're set for action. Matea a little hot about something.
Huh. He's trying to make a fool out of the referee or of Ivan Putski, telling the referee to pull his hair. He ain't got no hair. You know, Putski doesn't have the style of Rocky Johnson or Bob Backlund. But that Putski is truly a top wrestler. He has his own style. He knows what he's doing, and he's a powerful man. Good timing. Very, very successful wrestler. And if you want to test him and find out how strong he is, he'll let you do it.
Oh, every time. No, my.
And if you want to get him mad, he'll show you how mad he can get.
Scheduled up later on, Sergeant Slaughter takes on Tony Garea. That should be a great matchup. Interesting,
very,
Rogers
very
corner.
Exciting.
And also, we certainly await the presence of Superfly, Jimmy Snuka. Look at this. Putski hammering away on Matea.
One thing, once Putski gets hot, look out. He ain't going to stop for nothing.
And a six, the fans chanting as well. Whoa, in the ring the hard way.
Now he's going to pull a hair.
Sets him up to the rope. Oh, my. Cover. Ivan Putski never looked better.
Polish power!
Ivan Putski, who just may have pulled the amplifiers out with that last Polish power chant, we'll find out.
Here is a time, 2 minutes and 51 seconds, and the winner, the Polish power, Ivan Putski.
Ivan Putski victorious. Let's go to slow motion as we saw it moments ago now. Putski setting up Israel Matea. Oh, by the hair, look at him by the chin. Ooh, my, right down in the chest. A crushing blow by Ivan Putski. We take you now to Buddy Rogers.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. My guest this week is Arnold Skolin, manager of the World Federation Heavyweight Champion Bobby Backlund. Arnold, I'm here to defend myself. I'm glad I got you with me. I want you to bear me out on some things. I'm here to defend myself that I did not tell a lie about Bobby doing the Harvard step test. But let me tell you, I've walked the streets a lot, and a lot of old-timers say to me, Buddy, what do you think about the old-time wrestlers compared to the wrestlers of today? Well, ladies and gentlemen, you believe me, this might never happen again in wrestling. Arnold and I can honestly say we wrestled Jimmy Lundis, Gino Garibaldi, Ed Strangolewis, the Dusick brothers. We wrestled the best of years ago, and speaking of tremendous condition, I want you people to know that I manage Jimmy Snuka, and you know what great shape he's in. Well, let me tell you something. In my estimation, Bobby Backlund is the best conditioned athlete in the world today. Arnold, I want you to say something.
That is true, buddy. I'm proud to be his manager. And as I say before, you were not lying. We both saw that Bobby did it for a solid hour. And as you know, we did wrestle all those great champions. And Bobby Backlund, without a doubt, is the greatest. And I'm really proud to be his manager.
We'll be back.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the next contest is scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my left from New York City, weighing 235 pounds, it is Jose Estrada. And his opponent from the Fiji Islands, weighing 250 pounds. Here is Jimmy Superfly Snuka.
The Superfly, he is something. Snuka, oh my, standing ovation. Look at this. Standing ovation for the Superfly. No doubt a phenom in professional sport. Estrada going to work on Snuka. Here we go with the action. Snuka with Estrada. Estrada to the rope. Superfly gets a shot.
There's only one. I've never seen a wrestler being so popular like Snuka is. He is incredible. Everywhere he goes, they just want to see him. They want to touch him. They want to talk to him. And what a nice guy. What a super nice guy. And when he gives the fans the love sign, that's what he believes in. He believes in love.
Estrada hammering away to the midsection. Snuka tightens the grip on the front face lock.
Estrada is no dummy. He jumped him immediately, even before the bell rang.
And again, another rake of the face by Estrada. Certainly a reason for the referee to consider disqualification. To the chest area. Estrada falling on hard times as of late. Snuka up on a second rope now. Forearm and a fist more or less into the head of Jose Estrada. Estrada just about out of it now. Snuka measuring Jose Estrada. Snuka with so many, many fans. Unbelievable.
Snuka really his right eye turning red.
Oh, he caught a big one. Caught
he
a hard one by Estrada.
Just before the bell rang, Estrada jumped him and again.
Again, it may be because of that, the raking. And again, he goes back to the same eye. Lunge by Estrada. Headbutt by Snuka. Superfly as Estrada drops him down his back. Snuka out on the apron. Superfly, Snuka going up to the top rope. Snuka getting control of himself. Here comes Superfly.
Oh!
Snuka with that right eye almost closed took some abuse. We'll get the official time.
Here is the time, 4 minutes and 9 seconds, on the winner, Jimmy Superfly Snuka.
We took you back to action they saw moments ago. Here now, Jose Estrada. Up he goes, and Snuka drops him down on the knee. It was just about all over already at that point. Snuka quickly outside, up to the top rope. And you can bet these fans in anticipation, they want to see one thing. This. The leap, the dive, Superfly on the victory. As we return with Mick Johnston.
Mac Rivera looking on. Mac Rivera awaiting his opponent. Rivera, 246-pounder, giving away unbelievable size and strength, over 120 pounds, as a matter of fact, to the giant-like. Big John Studd, look at him. You would not want to get into this man's way. Not at all.
Well, Vince, he is, of course, one of the big giant in wrestling, and Fred Blassie's dream would be to have this man eliminate Andre the Giant from wrestling, and then Fred Blassie would be managing the only giant in wrestling. That would be Fred Blassie's dream.
Well, there is no doubt that the undefeated streak of Andre the Giant will come to an end sooner or later. Either that or he'll retire, which is not too likely to happen for many more years. So if any man can do it, this man can. Well, Big John Studd against Mac Rivera. Down to the canvas. Mike Rivera, good size, young man. But not, look at this. Looks like falling out of a tree.
Like to see if John Studd could do the same thing to Andre the Giant. As you mentioned, Vince, Andre is not an easy man to beat in the ring. No one has been able to beat him yet, but if someone has a chance, John Studd has a chance because of his size and his strength. And for a man of his size, 380 pounds, he moves well in the ring.
Oh, my. Forearm across the sternum area. Look at this. Fred Blassie has never managed a World Wrestling Federation champion. He himself has never been World Wrestling Federation champion, despite tremendous abilities by individuals whom he has managed, despite, as a matter of fact, his own substantial credentials when he was a wrestler, one of the all-time greats.
He was.
I wonder if in this man, Fred Blassie, does it have perhaps the next World Wrestling Federation title holder?
Well, there's great possibility there, and the fact that also, Vince, whether Studd becomes a champion or not, the fact that he would be the only giant in wrestling, and he'd be in demand by all wrestling, he'd be in demand by all wrestling promoters, and that means a lot of money for Fred Blassie, and we all know that Fred Blassie, his first love is money.
Well, Big Mac Rivera across the back of huge Big John Studd. There's no contest there. No, sir. Fred Blassie steps into the ring to congratulate Big John Studd, number one indeed, and Fred Blassie's hope. Fred Blassie's free ride to the heights. Some of the fans about ringside not appreciating this man's talents. This size, he is huge. We take a look now at what we saw in the latter stages of the matchup. Big John Studd scooping up his opponent. Mac Rivera has him way, way up there. Better than 6 feet, 10 inches in the air, falling right out of that tree, right across the shoulders. destroying this man's back. Right up with the backbreaker. You wonder, can any one man, no matter how big, stop Big John Studd?
Welcome to Championship Wrestling. At ringside, this is Vince McMahon with wrestling great Pat Patterson. This week, we take another look at the tag team combination of Tony Garea and Eddie Gilbert.
Well, Vince, every time they're on television, I'm always impressed, and I really feel that they're going to go a long way. Now, Tony Garea has been tag team champions many times, and I'm sure that's one thing that's in his mind, the championship belt.
Scheduled as well to join us will be the Russian Bear, Ivan Kulov.
Well, I kind of nicknamed him La Machine. The man is really a machine, well-conditioned, former world champion. That's another thing that he has in his mind.
Speaking of champions scheduled, ladies and gentlemen, in a non-title event, the Magnificent Muraco.
Magnificent Muraco, Vince. I think he's overconfident. No doubt in my mind he's a great wrestler, but he's turned down some challenger. So it's questionable to see if he's afraid or not.
On the opening contest, it is a non-title bout. But first, I'd like to introduce the manager. It is Captain Lou Albano. And this bout is set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my right from New Haven, Connecticut, weighing 230 pounds, it is Jerry O. And in the corner to my left from Sunset Beach, Hawaii, weighing 247 pounds, ladies and gentlemen, here is the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, the Magnificent Muraco.
Mickey Mouse? That's not hardly Mickey Mouse. Muraco, one of the great competitors. Two-time holder of the Intercontinental title. This is a non-title matchup. Muraco set to take on Jerry O. We shall have action as soon as Mr. Albano removes his fat self. Muraco getting behind Jerry O. Nice takedown. Very nicely done.
Nice drop toe hold. You know, Vince, earlier
before... How about that? Clean break, Pat.
Well, that won't last very long. He's getting to be over-cocky, that Muraco. He was yawning a little while ago before the match.
Look at this. Try to take him over. No, sir. Muraco right on top of him. Look at this. Great balance possessed by Muraco. Brings him over. Look at that. Referee in position. Count of two. Back up, Muraco is so clever.
Look how cocky that man is.
This telecast is being brought to you by the authority of the World Wrestling Federation and Capital Wrestling Corporation. I'd like to remind you any rebroadcast or the use of the pictures, descriptions, or accounts, including the imposition of a charge without the express written consent of Capital Wrestling Corporation and the World Wrestling Federation, is prohibited. Jerry O with a side headlock on Muraco.
Vince, Muraco is the only wrestler to wear the
Intercontinental Champion. No, I think Federer more or less.
Nicely done. Suplex. The point you're about to make, I believe, Pat, that both Morales and Muraco both have worn the Intercontinental title on two different occasions. Of course, it is Muraco currently wearing it.
Yeah, that's a big difference right there.
Look at this. Oh, my, driving those knees into the back.
That Muraco can really get vicious when he wants to.
Jerry-O to the rope. Look at this. Suplex by Muraco. Cover. Count of three. All right, now there you have it. With Muraco, Pat.
Did you see him what he did?
Sure. Now he wants to be, that's it. He wants to have his hand raised by Luis Albano. We will get the official time, after which we'll take a look at action.
Here is the time, 2 minutes and 50 seconds, and the winner is the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, the magnificent Muraco.
Muraco victorious to slow motion we go. Here, Jerry O, who took quite a drubbing. Muraco, well, just way too much class for a Jerry O. Here, look at this. Into what you'd think would be a fair hug, but no, it's a driving suplex from there. Great position, Muraco continuing to drive up on his toes, driving his shoulders down, and of course the win already knocked out.
Welcome to Championship Wrestling. Here at ringside, this is Vince McMahon, along with wrestling great Pat Patterson, where this week we'll take another look at dynamic Tito Santana.
Tito Santana is coming a long way, and you know, Vince, he's been very, very successful with that step-over toehold that he does. And I'm telling you, every time he applies that hold, no one can get out of it, and he's been winning all his matches with it. And I have a feeling that we're going to see him this week do that again.
Also scheduled to join us in a special six-man tag team matchup. One side will see Samoan 1, 2, and 3.
Well, two Samoans is enough right there. It's plenty. And three of them, anything could happen. And, of course, in a six-man tag match, there's always a lot of action. And it should be wild and exciting.
Also scheduled to join us will be the tag team combination of the Invaders. Plus, ladies and gentlemen, a most interesting interview that was pre-recorded earlier on. A most interesting interview with the one and the only Superfly, Jimmy Snuka. Notwithstanding, on hand this week, the magnificent Muraco.
Well, the whole wrestling world, I don't have to tell you, the whole wrestling world is rumbling right now because of what happened last week. And as you mentioned, you'll hear all about it when Mr. Snuka speaks to us.
On the opening contest, it's scheduled for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. It is a tag team match. Introducing in the corner to my left, from Sioux City, Iowa, weighing in at 255 pounds, it is Bob Bradley. And his partner from Puerto Rico, weighing 239 pounds, it is Mac Rivera. And their opponent from Puerto Rico, weighing in at a combined weight of 460 pounds, here are the Invaders.
The Invaders, who've had quite a bit of success as of late in the World Wrestling Federation, taking on the combination of Bob Bradley and Mac Rivera, who have not had a great deal of experience in tag team fashion functioning as a unit. The Invaders preparing for the matchup.
Thank you.
Bradley taking a vicious body slam a moment ago to the rope. There's the back body drop. More damage done to the back, and that has to be awfully painful, Pat.
Definitely, and that's why he's staggered out. He can't take it. I tell you, Vince, the Masked Invaders, they really show good wrestling ability. Not only that, they really display good tag team work, and that's what tag team is all about, tagging in and out, and that's what they're doing.
Invader 2 back to the corner. Mac Rivera with a series of knees, and now for the rise. Invader number 2 to the corner. Back out, look at this. Oh, nicely done. Oh, my. And a drop kick. The Invaders getting themselves together here, and the referee trying to maintain some control. The Invaders, both of whom execute quite an effective drop kick.
They do, both of them. And you know what's nice about them, what's so good about them being a team, is that they both about the same size. They both look alike. And when in that situation, you can, if you know how to utilize a referee, you can really get ahead.
Look at this, and a double tackle. Down goes Mac Rivera, right back up, however. Now with a slam. Invader number 1 in there, working on Mac Rivera. Somewhat of a double team attempt there a moment ago. And now, Pat, as you were alluding to earlier, it's difficult to tell the difference between these two Invaders. If they wanted to, they certainly could use that to their advantage as it relates to chicanery.
Well, without a doubt, they can really confuse their opponent to which one is legally in the ring.
As well as the official.
The referee's back could be turned, they can make a real quick switch, and it's really, really helpful to them.
Forearm smash to the chest, another chop to the throat area, a little higher. And Rivera has taken some punishment here in this match.
Rivera is a big man, was about 250, 255, and they really picked him up easy and slammed him. The Invaders, they really take their time, they don't rush into things.
Look at this.
Nice maneuver.
Oh, yes, very nicely done. Tag is made, Invader 2 now. To the rope, look at this, over the hip, now to the chest. Cover. And a 3 count.
It's a beautiful maneuver that they do, but somehow it should not be legal because both men are in the ring at the same time, but somehow they get away with it.
So we'll get the official time.
Here is the time, 3 minutes and 30 seconds on the winners, the Invaders.
The Invaders victorious. I would suspect there's a look at some of the fans in this capacity crowd this week. I would suspect that we will no doubt see more of the Invaders in weeks to come as we take you down in slow motion. Here, setting up for the cover. Very nice maneuver here. It looked as though it was going to be a suplex, only to be the knee to the back area. The tag is made, and here a couple of seconds are granted by the referee in order for one Invader to get out of the ring after tagging the other. However, as you bring out, Pat, perhaps a little bending of the rules here. Let's go back up for another matchup.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the next contest scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my right from Newark, New Jersey, weighing 225 pounds, it is Tony Callahan. And his opponent from Detroit, Michigan, weighing 288 pounds.
Well, the ring announcer, Joe McHugh, who's getting up in age, wasted no time at all in escaping. Not even the weight. Well, the announcement, to complete the announcement, is the Animal now has stepped into the ring. He is truly one of a kind.
Animal right back over on Tony Colon.
You see that earlier, the Animal was trying to tell the referee, you get out, I don't need you. Well, of course he doesn't need the referee, he breaks all the rules and he gets away with it. There's no rhyme and reason for this man. There's that submission hold again that he's very successful with, and the match is over.
And look at this. Don't tell me. Look, look, the Animal. Over in the buckle now, that's, oh, that yucky stuffing. Look, throwing it up in the air. Look, dodging it. Again, we've said, this man, the most unorthodox individual in professional sport today. Look at him. Raining the stuffing down, all down into his face. Look at him. Look at that. Oh. Are you?
He looks like he's playing with it, or he's amazed of what's in it.
Yeah.
Look at that. Complete mess of the ring.
We'll get the official time.
The time, 1 minute and 13 seconds on the winner, George the Animal Steele.
The Animal victorious. We'll take another look at some of the antics of the Animal. Is here. He goes down deep inside the buckle. The only man, I guess, in the history of wrestling to have a rather unusual relationship with the corner. Up goes the stuffings, and in from there, looking up in the celestial heavens, the Animal, as all that garbage just comes down, all down into his back as he backs off and looks at it and wonders to himself exactly what's going on. The Animal victorious. We're in the process of cleaning up the ring, after which we shall return with a newcomer from Korea. His name, Tiger Chung Lee.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the next contest, scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit, introducing in the corner to my right, from Chicago, Illinois, weighing 229 pounds, making his first appearance in this arena, here is Steve Garea. And his opponent, from Korea, weighing 270 pounds, he is also making his first appearance in this arena. Here is Tiger Chung Lee.
Tiger Chung Lee, along with his manager, Freddie Blassie. What do you know about Mr. Lee?
Well, I've saw him many, many years ago, and I tell you what, he looks better than he did. I haven't seen him in a long, long time. He was a lot heavier than that, and I tell you one thing, he's a very aggressive wrestler, and he's the type of man that Mr. Blassie likes to manage. That's probably why Mr. Blassie went all the way to Korea to bring him here in the United States.
Chung Lee going to work on Steve Gray. Chung Lee kicking away. That's about all he's done thus far on Steve Gray. And Gray now trying to mount an offensive to the midsection. Has very little effect, if any.
Well, Lee used to be able to display a lot of wrestling maneuver. And so far, he has not displayed any wrestling at all.
Ooh, look at that back kick. Nicely done.
Right on the
cover. That was enough to knock him out. Caught him right on the butt of the jaw. You could hear the smack. Tiger Chung Lee bowing to Mr. Freddie Blassie. And Chung Lee has really destroyed his opponent.
Here is the time, 1 minute and 25 seconds. It is the winner, Tiger Chung Lee.
Tiger Chung Lee victorious. And we'll take another look at what we saw earlier on. Here, Tiger Lee with a shot down into the pectoral area, and watch this. Boom, right up on the butt of the jaw. As a result of that, back to live action will go. Unfortunately, it appears as though Steve Gray, is still out on it. Not cold. Cold as a cucumber.
Really did, right on it. But
we'll have to get the doctor in.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the next contest, scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit, introducing in the corner to my left from Italy, weighing in at 230 pounds, here is Salvatore Bellomo. And his opponent in the corner to my right from Santo Domingo, weighing 240 pounds, here is Israel Matea.
Israel Matea gets a thumbs down by some of the fans about ringside as he prepares for his matchup with a fine young wrestler in Salvatore Bellomo. Here we go. Referee asking Mr. Matea about the alleged yank of the hair.
Well, Matea is quite happy because he realizes the referee is really buying his script. The referee comes up and asks him if he really pulled a hair. We know, obviously, that Palomo did not have to pull a hair. Now, Matea did.
Well, it would be quite difficult to pull the hair of Israel Matea.
Palomo doing quite well for himself, Vince, but he's still having a hard time now and then with some of the big guys. And he's not complaining. He says, as long as I'm doing my best, as long as I'm happy, making the fans happy, that's all that matters to me.
Back body drop, nicely done by Israel Matea. Matea setting Palomo up again. No leapfrog this time. Heel kick into the chest. Head of drop.
Beautiful drop kick after the mule kick, and that mule kick is not easy to do, I'll tell you. You have great timing. You got to know when to do it, too. Matea, after that drop kick, doesn't want to get back in the ring too soon. He's doing the right thing, taking his time, trying to recuperate. Huh. No chance with Bellomo.
Nice maneuver.
Beautiful head scissor. Another one. Different style, of course, of head scissor.
Up across the back. What's he going to do with it, Pat?
Bellomo is trying to give him an airplane spin. He does not have him hooked right.
Covers him. Two, and he gets three.
There he goes. He didn't have him right up there. He could have dropped him.
Here is the time, 2 minutes and 31 seconds. The winner, Salvatore Bellomo.
Salvatore victorious. Congratulated by this capacity crowd. We'll take a look at some of the action that we had earlier on in the matchup. Here we go now, off the rope. And from here, you recall earlier on, Bellomo took a back body drop. On this occasion, timing so perfect. Mule kick right into the chest, down below, actually, the left pectoral, down into the rib area. And from there, look at that. Foot right on the left foot right on the head of Israel Matea. That was just about all she wrote for Mr. Matea. But with his European style, he's doing extremely well for himself and garnering fans by the thousands. Salvatore Bellomo, a young man on his way to the top in the World Wrestling Federation. We'll be back as we continue with Tito Santana, Buddy Rogers Corner with Ivan Koloff, the magnificent Muraco, and more.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the next contest, scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit, introducing in the corner to my right, from Mission, Texas, weighing 235 pounds, here is Tito Santana. And his opponent, from Montreal, Canada, weighing in at 262 pounds, making his first appearance in this arena, here is Paul the Butcher Vachon.
Well, the Butcher is quite some wrestler. Experience galore. A further word on the Butcher later on. Right now, we're set for action. Sudden, it's time to back off a little bit for the Butcher. Now, Pat, you are keenly aware of the Vachon family of wrestling, are you not?
Incredible. Canadians from Montreal, and two of them, one of them is Mad Dog Vachon, this one is Butcher Vachon. And this man right here, Butcher Vachon, has wrestled everywhere in the world, in India, everywhere in Europe. He's been all over the world, well experienced. He's a tough customer.
Santana. Oh, this man has a lot of fire. Vachon to the corner.
Vachon can take a lot of punishment. A lot of time he'll make you think he's really hurt, and he's not. And Tito knows that. He's being very careful. I tell you, Vince, Tito is getting so popular, and there's good reason to. He's a fine young man. He's a good-looking young man. He's a good wrestler. You can't ask any better than Tito Santana when you watch him in the ring. You know he's going to do his best all the time.
Down to the leg. Vachon, again, the veteran, holding to the ropes. Referee asking for the clean break and gets it.
The average wrestler would have pulled Vachon right into the middle of the ring. Tito's trying to play fair all the time. He's trying to wrestle fair.
Right.
Let go.
Oh, almost took him down. Look, Vachon. Little disgruntled over his latest attempt at a takedown. Now, single leg takedown, kick out by Santana, kind of letting, well, it was almost a sucker maneuver on the part of Santana.
Santana real quick, right back up before Vachon could get up.
Single leg takedown is effective, but for you amateurs, not nearly as effective as a double leg takedown. Oh, standing position, side elect by Santana as Vachon tries to power his way out of it. Now he's going to try a little different tactics. To the ropes. Shoulder block knocks Vachon down. Off the rope, Santana. Waiting for the back body drop, leapfrog, Santana. Whips him right over to him.
Tito moves real well. He looks good. He has more confidence now than he ever had before. He's going to go all the way to the top. There is no question about it. That's where he wants to go, and he's going to make sure he gets there. No matter what price he has to pay.
Vachon risking disqualification, choking Santana. Boy, he really was. Santana coming out of this. Up goes Vachon. Cool. What a body slam.
Beautiful body slam.
Santana, drop kick, nails him with the butt of the jaw. Santana off the rope. Oh, what a forearm that was. Tremendous forearm. Up and down. Three count.
Beautiful. You know, I'm surprised he didn't use his famous leg lock. And that's good that he did, because he has to change that thing around sometime, because too many wrestlers expect that leg lock to come up sometimes, and now he's surprised with somebody else, with something else.
Here is the time, 3:48, and the winner, Tito Santana.
Oh, Santana, a force to reckon with in the World Wrestling Federation. We take you now. What we saw earlier here, has him up. Tremendous body slam by Santana. Now watch this, Santana with a drop kick that Paul Vachon, the Butcher, will be remembering for some time to come. From there, watch this forearm. No one gets a flying forearm like Santana does. And in from there, here we go, as Paul Vachon fights the dust, and a tremendous victory on the part of Tito Santana. The views expressed in Buddy Rogers' corner, those of Mr. Rogers alone, not necessarily those of us here on Championship Wrestling or this station. With that in mind, we take you to Gentleman Buddy Rogers.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. My guest this week is a sensational Sergeant Slaughter and his manager. All right. And his fabulous manager, The Wiz. It seems like he wants me to stand up to interview him.
You know, Rogers, when I was in the Marine Corps, I did all the talking. I gave all the questions. How about if I ask you some questions tonight?
You be my guest.
You know, ladies and gentlemen, right here you have Buddy Rogers. A legend in professional wrestling. He held the WWF title. He held the NWA title. And one question I'd like to say to you, Buddy Rogers, what do you think are my chances of being the world champion around here? What do you think about my chances? You think I'm probably the greatest wrestler you've ever seen in the world today?
Well, let me answer that with one phrase. You have to beat Bob Backlund to get that title. And what you did to Backlund, I'll never forgive you, and neither will them people out there. So take it from there.
Listen, Rogers, you're nothing but a low-life maggot to me. I used to respect a man like you, but I don't respect you anymore. I never did like you, and the way you're looking at me right now, I ought to slap your jaw off. Well, let me tell you one thing. You couldn't carry my bag to the dressing room, Rogers. You couldn't do anything I could do. How does it feel now to have a man as good or better than you are standing here next to you? With that, why don't you take it back to ringside?
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's been his way all along. And with that, we'll go back to ringside wrestling. Thank you.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the next contest, it is a non-title bout scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my right, from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, making his first appearance in this arena, here is Nick DeCarlo. And his opponent in the corner to my left, from Sunset Beach, Hawaii, weighing in at 255 pounds, ladies and gentlemen, here is the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, the Magnificent Muraco.
Well, Mr. Morocco's talent certainly unappreciated by this capacity crowd, especially considering what went on just last week between himself and Mr. Snuka. You can hear these fans. They all want Snuka.
Well, Vince, all I can tell you is what Muraco did to Snuka, there was absolutely no reason. Muraco wants recognition He has recognition. He's the Intercontinental Champion.
What he had recognition all along. What he wanted was respect.
Well, he ain't getting it now. And I tell you, what he did may cost him his wrestling career or his championship if he ever steps in the ring with Snuka. That I guarantee you. I think more than his championship. You know, that's what he lives for, Muraco, is the championship belt. And you take that away from him, you take everything he's got. He is more proud of that. And if someone takes the belt away from him, he is lost, completely lost.
All right, Muraco now just about ready to lock up with his opponent, Nick DeCarlo. Lou Albano, he better keep his mind on the magnificent Muraco. Drop kick missed by a mile.
Muraco can take a lot. He knows what he's doing, even though he's hurt. He's always aware of what could happen to this belt. Oh, reverse pile driver, and that's going to be it. Well, regardless of what we can say about Muraco, you can't take his wrestling ability away from him. That's one thing that he has, wrestling ability, timing, psychology. Muraco has it all.
Again, you hear the chant. We want some. Thousands of them. It seems like everyone wants Snuka but this man.
Here's the time, 2 minutes and 31 seconds. The winner, the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, the magnificent Muraco.
Muraco victorious. As we take a look at what we saw moments ago, here, Nick DeCarlo up, missed drop kick, and in from there, of course, was all she wrote. Magnificent Muraco with things well in hand. On his way to victory. We'll be back with a special six-man tag team matchup, after which, don't forget our interview with the Superfly.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the next contest, it is a six-man tag team match, introducing the corner to my right, from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing 240 pounds, it is the special Olympic. From Boston, Massachusetts, weighing 227 pounds, here is Chuck Tanner. And in the corner to my left, from the Isle of Samoa, weighing another combined weight of 860 pounds, here are the Wild Samoans on the 1, 2, and 3.
Apa, Sika, and Samula. All three Samoans, two of whom, of course, are tag team champions, Apa and Sika. The only tag team combination to ever hold the World Wrestling Federation championships on three different occasions. Look at that fat, grotesque slob, Albano.
Incredible, incredible at Lou Albano. He is such a slob, but he knows what he's doing, without a doubt. He's managed 14, 15 championship team. Obviously, he knows what he's doing, but he sure is a slob, as you say. Now, three Samoans. Two is bad enough. They're tough.
Here we go. Tony Garea against Samoan 3 in there, Samula. Tony Garea has been a co-holder of the tag team title on more occasions than any one man in the history of the World Wrestling Federation, so he knows what he's doing, functioning as a unit with his partners. Off the rope, nice shoulder block by Garea. Off the rope, over his man, right back at him. Look at that, leap block, back again. Oh, look at that. Drop kick to the chest by Garea. Another one. Hooks his man to hip, yanks him, no. Tony Garea with another drop kick. This time on Apa. Sika in there. SD tagging Tony Garea.
All right, SD and Tony looking real good.
SD tripping over Apa, right back.
Look at that, looking for SD. Beautiful.
Apa with very poor timing thus far. To the rope, missing with a chop.
Uh-oh.
Oh! SD chop. There's a newcomer in there now, taking over on Apa. At 227 pounds, I think, is announced weight. That's what you can do. Chop, moving his man back, drop kick, misses. Well, the action slowing down a little bit here as Apa takes over on Chuck Tanner.